When I am using my test setup, I've got these three buttons. I've got the X, Y, and Z button. Then over here, I've got a button for testing the touch probe. What happens is it's normally open. There's no contact from the top to the bottom. Then when I want to test it, I push this button and it makes a contact. This is called a normally open switch. The problem that I'm having is that with the touch probe, it's the exact opposite. Let's take a look at the inside of a typical probe. As you can see, there are three metal rods. These rods make contact whenever something is not pressing against the probe, so it's normally closed. Then, when something hits the probe, it pushes these rods up and they break the contact. Then, when the object is removed, the contact is established again. So what I need to do is I need to come up with a circuit to reverse this, to make it look like a normally open device to match the switch. So to make this work, what I'm going to do is I'm going to use a relay. A relay is what's called an electromechanical device, which means simply it has an electronic component and a mechanical component. So, starting at one side, you have a coil. This coil will create a magnetic field and cause the switches to change. So the first set of pins is common. That's where you would put your input signal at. Then you have what's called a normally open pin. It's normally not connected to the common. Then you have a normally closed. What that means is without any power, this switch is normally closed. So the signal gets routed out through that pin. So if we bring a battery in and connect it up, nothing really happens. But then when we connect the other side of the battery, the coil makes a magnetic field and the switch is pulled closed. Now the one that was normally closed is open and not connected, whereas the one that was normally open is now closed and the signal routes there. So it effectively reverses the signal, which is exactly what we need. Well, as you can see, I've built up my little circuit. So that is the relay, and this little cable here is where I'm going to connect my probe. Then, since I had two extra outputs on the other side, I put a couple of resistors and I connected it up to two LEDs so that as it goes, I can see what the status is. And then over here is where I'll attach it to the PC for the probe output. So let's give it a test. I've got the circuit on and we have a yellow LED indicating that there's no contact. Now this is the connector going to the probe and it comes back over here and this is the actual probe. So in theory, when I touch this probe, that should change. So let's see if it works. Yay! Now it's reversing. So the only time I get a signal out is when something's touching the probe. Well, if you're going to mount this thing, you need a panel. So I put together a panel. You can see my circuit board there. I got it mounted. And it dawned on me that, see, I got this thing working real good. This is simulating the signal going to the computer. And you can see it's changing the way it's supposed to. A little shadow there so you can see that better. The problem is if I disconnect the probe, that it's going to go to... like a contact all the time mode, see? So I had to put in a switch so that I could disconnect it. So whether this has power off or power on with no probe, it'll now look like that. Otherwise, whether it had power on or power off, it always looked like a detection.
So basically what I'll do is when I am ready to go, I'll have my drivers all turned on, because it comes on automatically when I put my axes on. And when I want to use the probe, I can just plug it in and it's ready to go. But if I want to test the probe and I don't want to send signals to the computer, I can just disable it. So I can test the probe out as much as I want without getting false signals.
Nice.